Hi, and thanks a lot for listening to this tutorial video on HashiCorp specification test using Stellar. So, first of all, you need to know that HashiCorp specification test is a sequential hypothesis testing on parallel data analysis, which have three stages. So, in the first stages, we test for the total homogeneity of our coefficient. So the first stage, if we accept the null hypothesis, meaning that our coefficient, our model is totally homogeneous. So rather, if we we reject the null hypothesis, it means that we should test if whether or not all coefficient of all explanatory variable coefficient are independent of individual. So it is at this stage, if we reject the null hypothesis, mean that the model is totally heterogeneous, meaning that we should estimate one model by individual, so we should not have panel data estimation. So it's not a good thing to estimate panel data analysis. So if we rather accept the null hypothesis at this stage, it means that we should test for the last hypothesis to know whether or not we should estimate a individual effect model or a pool model. So at this stage, if we accept the null hypothesis, it means that we should estimate a pool model using our data. So rather, if we reject the null hypothesis, it means that we should estimate an individual effect model. And at this stage, we can proceed to Hausmann specification test to know whether or not we should estimate a fixed or random effect model. So let us go to the next step in Stellar. So in Stellar, you need to I told you that I will give a descriptive a link in the description of this video to show you how where you can download HashiCorp specification test. So you will download a file like this, which is the code that you will implement in your Stellar command in order to test for HashiCorp specification test. Is this file that you will see on the video description. So in this file, we have n is a number of individual. We have t, which is number of observation date, and k is a number of explanatory variable. So for value of individual going to 1 to 11, you should proceed this all these codes. So what you need to set in this is to select first of all, instead you need to set your data to be panel data. So you just need to tap XT set following by individual variable and peer variable. So you can set your data to be a panel data. So after that step, you need to just copy your code and paste it in your data command. So you should set up the number of individuals. In this case, I have 11 individuals. I have 14 observation by date, by individual, and I have 6 explanatory variables. So from the value I here represent the variable individual. In my database, variable individual is represented by this variable sugar should replace I by the individual variable in my code. So after that, the second step, the following step is to set the variable equation. So we have explanatory variable following by we have dependent variable followed by independent explanatory variable. So I have my dependent variable here, and I just double click to select the explanatory variable. So I have 6 explanatory variables. In this case, I can just copy the equation and replace at any specification, any regression estimation in my code. So lastly, I have this estimation of my model. So once I have replaced equation in my code, I can just execute so at the end of this of this code, we have the result of our test. We have F statistic, Fisher statistic, first value of Fisher statistic 6.55. Now the second value, which is 1.98, and the third value, which is 23.33. And we have our probability value that are 0, 0, and 0, which means that at each stage. So at the first stage, if we come back in this decision tree, we can see that at the first stage, we reject the null hypothesis because the p-value is 0, which means that at 5% level, we can just reject the null hypothesis, meaning that the model is not totally heterogeneous. So at the second stage, we also reject null hypothesis, meaning that we should not look at the third stage of our test, meaning that the model is totally heterogeneous, meaning that we should estimate one equation by equation by individual. So panel data is not interesting to analyze those data. So thanks very much for listening to this tutorial video. I hope it helped you very well understand how to run Hausmann specification test using Stata.